Hey guys, welcome to the Swapmoto Live Show presented by OGIO Powersports and FMF Racing. I'm Don Maeda and I'm joined, I think, for the third or fourth time by my buddy Ryan Villopoto, the best retired racer in the entire world. Do you like that title?
I like that title. Thank you, Don.
It's completely true.
I just feel weird with this thing here still.
Oh, the COVID thing,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Well, you've already had COVID, you said, so.
Have you?
I think I had it last February, but I tested negative on that antibody thing, so.
I don't know. We're still here talking about it, I guess.
Yeah. Hold on. I'm also a blood type O.
Okay.
And they say that blood type O is resistant to it, so, I mean, who knows?
Yeah, you're just superior.
So when was your COVID?
Over Thanksgiving.
Oh, really?
Yeah, right over Thanksgiving. So I was a super spreader. I gave it to the rest of my family, grandma, grandpa. I said, you're welcome. Now you don't have to worry about, you know, walking around, going to get it, not going to get it. I just gave it to you. So.
Yeah. The kids didn't get it, though, right?
I don't even know. Yeah. I couldn't tell you if they had it or didn't have it.
Yeah.
But it was like the cold. I wouldn't even call it a bad flu. For us, anyways. And really nobody in our family.
Mm-hmm.
So.
All right. Dude, so there's been a lot going on for you. Like, you're retired, but you're still not living the life of leisure, right? You still have a lot of things going. I think the biggest news for you, correct me if I'm wrong, but is your association with Canvas now, right?
Yeah.
So it's your brother-in-law.
Brother-in-law, yeah.
Your brother-in-law, because Michael Leib married your sister.
That's right.
But regardless of that relationship, would you have gone this route?
So obviously, myself and Michael, being that before they were married, you know, they'd come to the house and, you know, just we've talked about it here and there. And I said, yeah, it'd be, you know, like, and as things progressed, moved forward, and, you know, for me, obviously, being retired and kind of getting moving, eventually you're going to be not relevant, right? So, my thought process was, while I'm still somewhat relevant as a now retired, you know, ex-racer, you know, try to start something more or get involved with something bigger than just going out and looking for, you know, a quick paycheck here or there. And, you know, I talked to Michael about that and obviously him have starting Canvas, I think, roughly around 5 years ago.
Is it only been that long?
It's pretty new, and him and Chuck basically started this thing and have done all of it on their own.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the trial and the errors and learning, you know, the manufacturing side, the product, the materials, all these things. You know, so it's progressed and slowly grew, and it was kind of like the perfect timing where they were like pretty much getting ready to work, you know, taking somebody on like myself. And I was like, okay, well, this definitely could totally make sense in, you know, in the future to, you know, move into a position to where help build this brand and take on more of a role in building something and having a little piece of the pie also, instead of, like I said, going out and looking for that quick paycheck, you know? So,
yeah.
So far it's gone. We did a little bit of a soft launch because my answer deal was out and we had that pit bike race coming in. So I had to get in something. So you guys have all seen me in the black kit that was this design. But we're going to go to a full launch here. I think it's in the next 2 to 3 weeks is the plan. So,
yeah, man, that video, you went to Ocotillo, right?
Yeah, so. Yeah, yeah.
I was salty when I saw that. Dude, you didn't call Chase and I to come. I'm like,
well,
dude.
I guess I didn't set it up. I let Michael
set
it up.
Well, yeah, Michael uses Jacob Johnson, right?
Yeah.
So there's a relationship there.
There is
I'm
a
like,
relationship,
dude,
yeah.
RV. I thought we were your guys.
Yeah, well, you know.
I mean, dude, to get to see you play ride like that, I would.
It was, so to be honest, we were trying to figure out what to do. And obviously there's been a lot of things shot. I mean, nothing hasn't been shot in California.
Yeah.
And we were trying to figure out something that we could do fairly quick. Because it was coming down to crunch time. I was leaving to go to that race, that pit bike race. And I was like, okay, we got to do something. And Michael's like, oh, what about Ocotillo? I was like, yeah, I had only ever been out there once on an 80 with Reed Nordine way back in the day. We camped and rode. And I was like, yeah, let's go out there. And you know, it was pretty funny because they're like, oh, what about this jump? What about that? I'm like, well, I don't really want to do any big jumps.
Yeah.
You know, and I just find the littlest stuff and be able to, like, you know, I say, hey, just work the camera a little bit and we'll get a good shot here. And everything turned out pretty good. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah. I would think you could have took like a spotter rider, right? Like to get like handy with you or something, like show me the line.
Well, actually, Jacob actually knows it pretty well. So,
oh yeah, he's a good rider.
Yeah, so then we, you know, and we work, like I said, crunch time. We were like, okay, we're wanting to get there, you know, during flat light, get dressed, get kind of comfortable, and then get towards the end of the sun, like where the sun's coming down and the better light. So, but it all worked out. We did it in about 3.5 hours.
Wow.
And that's what we came up with. So it worked out really well.
Cool. So it's also a good business move for you too, right? It's,
I mean, that's ultimately, you know, our hope, you know, Michael's hope, bringing somebody like myself into it. And then myself, you know, my hope coming into it and merging and, you know, hopefully getting this, building this good team and foundation to then, you know, get a good trajectory on, and we don't have to like hit a home run right away. That's really not the plan to, you know, obviously everybody's like, oh, what would you like to do? Well, obviously we all want to hit a home run, right? But that's really not the goal. The goal is just to have a nice and work into our position and who we are as a brand and being able to, you know, build Swapmoto gear if you want gear tomorrow, or, you know, literally in 2 weeks we can custom design you gear and have it on your doorstep, you know, in 2 weeks. Or, and then also building Canvas, the brand itself also. So there's kind of going to be two layers of it, from the custom side, from you know, somebody that has a group of dudes that are a riding group that wants to have, you know, whatever name it is, you can put it on your gear, have it designed, and make it, you know, your own custom stuff. So there's that entity of it, and then also the brand Canvas. So it's going to be pretty fun, pretty cool project.
What has been the feedback you've gotten from friends, industry people, and stuff on this move?
So far, like I said, the soft launch. So you'll see a lot more here coming up here pretty soon. Everything's been pretty, they were stoked on the kit, that we had, the kit that I wore, this kit here. This is the black kit.
It's funny because Chase was just like texting me, dude, this is so sick, you know, but.
And it turned out really well. You know, obviously, I wish I would have been, I'm a little, you know, I wish I was a little slimmer to be in that kit, you know, I'm not that athlete anymore like I used to be, but, you know, it fits really well. It's stretchy. It holds up pretty well. You know, it's all together. Everything we've had, our platform right now is really good. And our goal is to get even better. Our goal is to be one of the very top brands.
So you coming in, have you had input on the design and the fit and function?
I'm not much of a design guy. Okay, I mean, I'll tell you what I like and what I don't like. Yeah. You know, and maybe change this, maybe change that. So, and once I got a kit for myself, put them on, the pant, the jersey, I was like, oh, well, you know, like, it's for Michael and Chuck not being obviously, you know, a gear company and relatively new at it. Like, they've done a really good job with the chassis and the jersey. But our plan is to make it great, to make it one of the best sets on the market. So,
yeah, well, let's see this stuff.
It's just like, you know, we're not reinventing the wheel on any of this stuff.
It's sublimated, right?
That is all sublimated, yes.
So you can order whatever you want on a canvas.
Swapmoto Live, you know, whatever, you can put your sponsors on it.
It can all be put on. Like ordering it.
It's like 2 weeks. So as
For
it
real?
Comes in, it's 2 weeks.
So is it made in the U.S. then?
It's right over by Anaheim Stadium. So like literally, we can see the backside of the stadium.
Oh, so U.S. made.
Yep. So obviously, products or materials are, you know, are made all around and shipped here, but it is printed and sewn. Everything is sewn and printed right there, you know, so it's pretty cool.
Oh, these are all super stretchy, right?
Yeah, so we have right
these
now.
These are some big pants, RV.
Stop. Stop it. I'm trying to lose weight, Don.
But yeah, no, these are sick. So
we'll get you a kit here
Did
soon.
You, oh, no zipper either, right?
No zipper
That's
on those,
cool.
no.
No,
That's cool. no, so.
Did you?
And it even fits the bigger guys like myself.
Do you make it big enough for Dahmer? Like size 40 something?
All custom, whatever he needs.
Yeah, custom?
Whatever he needs.
But pants, 2 weeks too?
Yeah, the whole kit.
Dude, that's unreal.
So, I'm pretty stoked on it. It, like I said, it wears nice. It feels good. You know, like for hot and obviously all of the gear that's out there today. And I think you've wore most of the stuff that's out there. It's all this... athletic materials. So yeah. I think it's on par with on most of the stuff that's out there right now.
Cool. Hey, we're going to take a quick break to hear from our sponsors. We'll be back for more with the coolest retired guy in the world. Hey everyone, welcome back to the Swapmoto Live Show presented by OGIO Powersports and FMF Racing. Don Maeda joined here by Ryan Villopoto. So we're talking about canvas. Ever since you broke the news, right? It's funny, you know, like when you're like want to buy a certain car, then that's all you see on the road, right? But since you broke the news, I've been noticing more and more canvas. And then you guys are making moves. You just picked up a couple high-profile amateur kids, right?
Yeah, so I guess you'd call me the new Beaker of the gear world. So
you going to be the gear guy?
I mean, I don't know. Yeah, that's kind of, I guess, one of the things that I could say I don't want to say good at it, but I kind of know, I guess, how to do that position a little more than others.
Yeah.
So right now we picked up Gavin Towers and Drew Adams. So, yeah. You know, they're both wearing the gear currently right now. Daytona, I guess, will be the first spring, first national that they will be wearing the kits in, and you'll see custom kits from us at those races for them. So it's pretty cool though. Like I just, you know, dealing with the Towers and in the Adams, the family. Like so far, it's kind of cool being that. I just want to keep the group really small. Like you know, five or six kids across the board, from big bikes to probably, you know, I don't know, 50s, 60s, whatever that is. I don't want to have a huge team of riders. I want to keep it small and elite and be able to show what we can do. And I think what across the board is what's different from any other gear company is we can make custom stuff for you. So, you know, like it's like we can get our designer, or we can get you know, a conversation with me and you, say, what do you want on your, you know, what do you like? What don't you like? What color is this, that, the next, and design your gear, and then you go out and run it, you know, that you've personally made.
Yeah.
And we can do, I guess, as many kits as you want. So that's really what I want to, you know, have these kids and be in something different. You know, I can remember myself as an amateur, you know, racing and at the time, it was like, Fox was all the ones up, you know, the Fox kit, you know, like that's what I always wanted to be, a Fox guy. You know, and I want to build that same, you know, want from these kids to be, I want to be in canvas, you know, because they're always in fresh kits or they're always in new designs and nobody has that design and look how sick that design is. And
stand out from everybody else.
And stand out, exactly.
like when you were amateur and early pro, the only way you were standing out was like with your puka shell necklace.
Yeah, and my long hair. Yeah, so exactly. Yeah, I mean that's part of it. You know, you're on a, you know, pro circuit at the time. We're all in Thor, and you know, and it's not a bad thing, but everybody matches.
Yeah.
Other than your red number plate that was, you know, that you had, and that's if you had it.
Yeah.
Other than that, you all kind of look the same, you know, which isn't a bad thing, but I think in today's world, and you know, we all want to try to figure out a way to stand out differently. And I think for marketing purposes, for these kids that are trying to come up, like, I think it's good to be stand out and not just blend in.
Okay, so when you went to recruit Towers and Adams, right? Like, did you have a hand in it personally? Like,
no, I did all of it.
Okay, so when you go talk to Gavin Towers, right? Hey, you want to wear canvas next year? Were you greeted with like, oh shit, it's RV? Heck yeah. Or was it more like you had to convince them?
Well, luckily, actually, like Towers wise, I had introduction help. So Wes Kane was my in with Towers, and then Beeks was my in with Adams. With Adams, you know. So it was like, hey, you know, like, you know, and obviously with me and this new kit and, you know, new brand, you know, I think that it automatically brings, you know, that like, oh, what is it? Like, okay, we kind of knew what it was, or what, you know, that there was something out there. Yeah. We've heard about it, but then, you know, like I
was shocked when I saw Towers in it on Instagram. I'm like, oh shit.
Yeah. Like, you know, it brings a validity to it. And then it's like, okay, well, you know, this is some legit stuff. I've wore it. You know, and like I said, I put it on. I don't think we're the best stuff out there. I'm gonna just be straight up honest. Like, we have a little work to do, but we're as good as 90% of the high end gear companies that are out there. And we're gonna get to the, you know, we're gonna make the moves. Our plan is, and we want to make the moves to be one of the best.
Cool. All right. The other thing you've got going on in your life now is the world of mini dadding. Right. I mean, not yet.
You know, they've asked a couple times to go ride in the last couple of weeks. You know, but like, I need to get them out again and get them to another race and kind of see what the. Now they're getting to where they're definitely growing. You know, like they're when we came out to one of the races there at Star West or State Fair. We didn't have starting blocks, you know, I guess that's my fault, you know, but like me and Michael were both holding him because they couldn't, even at four, I see these other kids. I'm like, God, you're four. Like, I don't know. We must just have short kids. Yeah. I don't know. There's something wrong with you. I don't know what the matter is. What's the, you know, but, they couldn't even touch the ground remotely close. So, we're holding them up. So I need to get him out there. Now it seems like, I think that they can, Gage for sure can hold his bike up now because he's definitely stronger. I think he's like 8 pounds heavier than Brax. Mm-hmm. Brax is like a rail. So, but get him out and to see if that's something that they, you know, if they want to do. I mean, I think they do.
I mean, that race at State Fair, for some reason that day I went, I forgot my cameras, right? I was more worried about racing myself, but I forgot my cameras. So I made a freaking video of you guys with my iPhone, right? Yeah. Dude, that thing got so many views because so many people are pumped to see RV the mini dad, right?
And well, so I mean, I'm not gonna disagree with that, but I was told by AC, and you gotta ask AC this, and maybe Chase knows, but that if you make a video from your iPhone, it gets, the algorithm wise, it gets pushed harder
on
than
Instagram,
a professional
video. On
Instagram,
I don't know about it on YouTube, that's true.
So, oh, you're talking YouTube.
On YouTube,
okay.
Yeah.
Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, but I mean,
I'm a likable
that
guy.
One, remember we did the one in that lot on the Stasics?
Yeah.
One went through the roof too.
I'm a likable guy, I don't know what to
you
say.
You are a likable. But, okay, so the approach that mini mom and mini dad have seem to be different, right? Because we're in the middle of the track and you're like, hey, this class that they're racing, this first time or whatever, is it like everyone gets a trophy thing? And I'm like, I don't know, I'll find out.
And, well, I'm just asking.
Well, like, no, I know, but I was still like, oh, that would be sick.
Well, so I there's only one winner and losers, that, you know, there's first, second, thirds, I get it.
So I got second.
What I didn't want to happen was if it was a first through last trophy, like some races are, whatever, that we'd be pieced out because I was trying to leave early.
Yeah.
And no, I left it there, and then they're like, hey dude, where's my trophy? I was like, oh well, you know, I don't know.
So that day in my class I got second, right? So I don't pick up the trophies, but I went up there and said, hey, is this starter class like 100% trophy? And they're all, no. And I'm all, hey, I got second. And I look, and the trophy has a big number two. And I'm all, it's like RV2. So I go, hey, let me have two trophies. And they're all right. And so I give them to your guys, and they're stoked, right?
Oh, yeah, they were.
And Kristen's all, yo, that's a participation award. Don't be happy about that.
Yeah, no, for sure. I mean, yeah, they didn't look. That was the first time, I didn't expect it, obviously, anything. Like, they had never rode or anything that had actually any real ruts or anything either.
Yeah.
So I was just pumped that they were that. When we initially started, Brack said, "I'm not racing." I'm like, "Well, you're full of shit. You're racing. I'm gonna make you're gonna race once, and then if you don't want to race after that, then okay, fine, whatever." So I get him out there and practice. Yeah, it's practice. Okay. I want to practice. Meh, out there, meh. Come back in. Okay. How was it? Yeah, it was good. All right, let's go up again. You know, why are we behind the gate this time? And I'm like, oh, because this practice is behind the gate. You know, and so then he takes off and goes, and then after the race, he comes back, and I was like, hey, you know, you just raced.
Really?
I was like, yeah, you. That's why the checkered flag was out there. I said, you liked it? Yeah, I liked it. Yeah, whatever. So, and then I tried to leave before they rode two classes, and I tried to leave before the last one just because I was over it. And they're like, no, I want to race all, I'm racing. I was like, all right, well, we'll see. I don't know. I got to get, like I said, I got to get them out again. I mean, they'll always ride, but we'll see where they're going to take the racing side.
That's cool. I got to go to the first MX Fight Club with you in, was that Ohio?
It was in Ohio, yep.
Yeah, so that was a really crazy time. If you think about where we are now, right, to then, as far as the COVID fear and uncertainty of how everything's going to go down, were you guys scared that you're going to get shut down somehow at that? Because it was the first.
I mean, that was the, for obviously in our industry, that was the first and only thing that had been done. So we tried to keep it pretty, no spectators. There were some locals that lined up on the fence.
Figured it out.
But no, I don't think we were, we had a couple guys there that were, I shouldn't say would have got us maybe completely out of it, but that, had some badges and certain things that we pulled some, if had to pull some strings would have been fine, I think. And at the time everybody was, and I guess everybody's still freaked out. We did temperatures, just to keep record of, if somewhere were to, I personally wasn't shut down or worried that we would have gotten shut down. Mm-hmm. Especially kind of where we were.
Where we were, yeah.
It was pretty secluded, even though we were in town, basically, it was a hard place. Hard place to find, I guess.
Yeah.
For the average person.
Cool. We're going to take another quick break. We'll talk more about Fight Club and so on and so forth.
Together to both reimagine and lift the bar on what a modern motocross helmet should be. Opt for the highest level of modern technology and energy dispersion with the Fly Racing Formula helmet, designed for an elevated defense against a wider range of real-world impact scenarios, globally engineered with the most advanced materials and technologies available. Outfit yourself with proven technology, lightweight performance, and elevated impact management with the Fly Racing Formula helmet.
What's up, guys? It's Brock Tickle. I ride for the JGR Yoshimura Factory Suzuki Racing Team. and I'm stoked to be back at the races. Planning my comeback to racing was cool to see. I have a lot of support behind me to get me here. FXR stepped up and invested in me, and I'm stoked to be part of them. FXR honestly kind of blew me away. All the product is awesome. The pants fit me awesome. The best fitting pant I've ever worn, and everything's sublimated and it looks good.
To put our adventures on hold. But now is the perfect time to prepare for their return. Amsoil has your back with fast, free shipping, and ordering has never been easier. Just look up your vehicle, select your product, add an oil change to your cart, and check out. Spend $50 on Amsoil products, and shipping is on us. Order now at amsoil.com.
Welcome back to the Swapmoto Live Show presented by OGIO Powersports and FMF Racing. So RV, we were talking about the Fight Club. Dude, that thing, I don't know if I'm recovered from it yet.
The drive home, it was shit, I did it there and back.
I know, but still, man. That was three, you know,
what was it? I think it was, Ohio. I think it was 40-something out, 38, 40 hours.
Yeah.
3 days there and then 40 hours back.
Yeah. That when I saw
you ended up with a van after it.
Yeah, I saw IT at Paula or Fox Raceway. He's oh sick demo. This is your fault that I bought this van. He's like, what do you mean? I go, you had to have that dang seizure, and I had to drive home with RV.
That's right. He but this van life, bro.
Yeah,
can't live without it.
Okay, so van life. You're like addicted to the build, right?
Yeah, I'm building my third one right now with Chad over at Motobox.
Motobox.
Yep.
And this one is a dually, right?
Yeah, so I'm going to do this one full open floor plan, basically more of a camper style. Mm-hmm. Or it would be like a small kind of motorhome camper. Be able to get one bike for sure, in it. If my plan is to get two bikes in it. It'll mm-hmm. It'll be tight in the middle. But
you get one of those sweet bumper racks.
I could get a sweet bumper rack, yes. I could do that for the dual sport, for the WR. That's all you need, really.
Okay, so then I saw you at the track the other day, and you're like, "Wow, let me check out your van," because I got the low roof short.
Yep.
And then you're like, "I'm thinking about getting one of these too as my daily driver."
Yeah, I mean, I have my truck now, and works great. But like, if I go want to bring my motorcycle with the boys, you got to go in sideways. So, yeah. And predicting that we start riding, even if they don't race, if we start riding a little bit more.
Yeah.
That would be the route to go, is to have a low roof as my daily driver. Mm-hmm. I drove the big one around most of the time.
Yeah.
In fact, after this is over, I'm going to go drive yours around the parking lot, see how she handles.
You know what got me on that trip is when you're like, "Hey, I'm going to go to sleep. You got to drive." And we were in Nebraska and it was real windy. And you're like, "All right." So like sometimes if you're like going like 80 and it's windy, it'll like slam on the brakes.
Yeah.
And then you went to sleep and I'm all, he's jacking with me. I'm driving. Cruise control 80. Wind hits and the, what is it? Like
I don't know. It's the stability control comes in.
Thing slams on the brakes.
It like veers to the right. If it hits you, dude, I don't know. It's weird.
Yeah. I might have
peed. I think it's worse.
Yeah, it is worse. But luckily, I don't know.
But maybe for the average person, it's better.
Mine doesn't have it.
Okay.
So I'm kind of excited.
Well, and you're
about
the
that.
Low roof, so the it's not a sail in the wind.
Yeah. But okay, so this Motobox thing, are you like involved in that somehow?
No, I'm not. You're actually not involved with it at all. Just me and Chad, I had him build my very first one. Mm-hmm. And loved it, and then I came up with a different design for my second one. And not that I didn't love that one, but I actually, my mom had built the 144 high roof mm-hmm. and made an open floor plan. And then I was like, well, shit, this is pretty cool having it open.
Yeah.
And I was like, well, I'm going to build another one like that, you know? So that's, it just kind of snowballed.
Dude, the one we drove home from Ohio, you sold it. How many miles did it have on it?
9,800 is what it had on it. So it was
brand new still.
It was brand new.
But you sold it for a shitload of money.
I did well on it. And I called Chad too, and he's like, really? Like, what are you really thinking about? And I was like, I know. You know, because basically he's got like five guys, you know, so he basically takes them and he has them all queued out. And, you know, mm-hmm. so if you want to get in, you have to kind of get on a waiting list.
Yeah.
Not that I would have had to get back in line, but he actually had a guy, right as I had sold mine, he goes, all right, well, he was kind of stressing on how he was going to build mine, when he was going to fit me in. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden he had a guy pull out, call him and say, hey, I'm not sure what floor plan I want. Like, I'm not sure. And he goes, all right, basically gave
back
his deposit. And he's like, gave him his deposit back. And he put me into that queue his queue was supposed to come in, like, I don't know, like 2 months after I'd, you know, mm-hmm. sold my van or whatever. So I secured one from Walters and then, you know, sold mine, bought that. And then Chad took mine in place of that dude's and started working on it. So it should be done here pretty soon.
Okay. How is the old Yamaha ambassadorship working? I was glad to see that they took advantage of you as a resource on the racing side finally.
Yeah, no, I had all summer I had a blast doing that with the guys over at Yamaha and Sergio, and kind of bummed that that ended up, you know, going away. Mm-hmm. So, but like we made major progress with the motorcycle and there's still tons of progress to be made with it. Mm-hmm. I just think that my personal opinion on it is it's probably the least developed motorcycle. Somebody gets on it and they spend a year or 2 years and they end up leaving, right? So mm-hmm. like it doesn't get developed, and then say Cooper pulls it this way and Chad pulls it that way, and then, you know, I don't think it's ever been really developed properly mm-hmm. Over a period of time. So I'd like to do some more of that, but obviously with the changing of hands as of right now, I haven't, you know, haven't done any of it. But but yeah, for the ambassador role, like, COVID's kind of really screwed a lot of that up, because a lot of that's in-person stuff could be a sales meeting, could be a bike launch. Yeah. But this summer I have plans to, you know, get back doing a little bit more riding, and I am racing this, vintage, the Boise vintage race, uh-huh. On an old, 125 that my buddy built. And then we'll do some other, I just want to get back out. Like, that's when I'll get back out there kind of riding. I don't know, just haven't, you know, hopefully these, you know, things start to like ease back up and we'll be able to do bike shoots or, you know, launches and, you know, more stuff like that.
You know, we do. We have the Trans Am vet race. I think it's coming up at the end of March maybe or something like that.
Is that what it is, Don?
I'm going to text it to you. I'm going to twist your arm into coming back out.
I mean,
what better way to debut this canvas kit than with a big race win, right?
That's right. Can we do three laps?
Three laps? Come on, man.
I get arm pumped. I'm already getting pumped up thinking about it. Mm. I got carpal tunnel in this one. The end of my thumb is numb now.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. How's e-bike life?
It's good. It's
good. I mean,
dude,
we were riding together like quite a bit.
I haven't rode in a little bit. I personally, actually, I got it. I have to...
Got a Yamaha now, right?
Yeah, I have to pick it up. I still haven't picked it up yet. But we did the ride up in
Sky Park,
yeah, and bike was really good. Mm-hmm. You know, it took a little bit used to the 27.5,
right?
Just because the Specialized was a 29er. But no, overall was really good. The power of the motor was good. The MTB mode was, you know, we were there with Brian, and he's like, this is what I run it in most of the time. So The response was really well with it. You know, so my plan is to actually, I want to build one up, you know, get a frame.
Get Fox stuff.
Yeah, get some Fox. You know,
are you going to go 29
or front? Not that the product's bad on it, but it's just like, I'm going to make it my own, you know, and put the stuff that I want on it. Like, there's different size forks you can do. You can go from all the way to from a 34 to like a 40 now, you know, so there's a bunch of stuff that I like call it testing or putting on there and seeing how it is.
I
want to do.
I was bugging Drew for it at the intro. I'm like, hey, dude, I think I would ride this all the time if you loan me one.
I'd
put a 38 fork on it with a 29er front, I think.
So it'd be like the mullet setup.
At Sky Park, that one Comet Trail, some of the root drop downs, I thought I was going to go with the bars because I'm not used to the smaller.
It's definitely different. That was, I think, my biggest thing coming from you know the 29er to that was like, and it's even worse when you go back to an old bike with 26. Yeah. You're like, dude, I feel like I'm riding a tricycle, like, you know, like with just tiny, tiny wheels. The evolution of like the bigger tires and wheels have come a long way. I definitely prefer a bigger tire, bigger wheel.
Hey, you know that left turn on Sith Trail and Holder Crooks?
That's where I crashed?
We call it the RV turn.
Oh, yeah, where I crashed.
Whenever I take something, like, oh, okay, there's the RV turn up here. What's that?
Blew it.
It just goes.
I blew it. So yeah, I was down in the other lane coming back down.
Yeah, good times.
Has it changed at all?
It's really good right now because of the rain.
Yeah. Any new trails or any?
Worked on it. Yeah, there's some new trails up there.
Really?
It's good.
I'll have to get out there.
Yeah. Well, hey, buddy, thanks for stopping by again.
Yeah, no worries.
I'll see you at the Trans Am, and hopefully before then we'll get some mountain biking in.
Let's do it, and we'll make you your custom kit.
Yeah, I want to get a canvas kit. Mine can't be white though, because white is like enlargening, right? It's got to be all black.
It can be all black, and you crash a lot, so you don't want white.
Right on, dude. Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. Make sure to check out canvasmx.com. That's right?
Yep.
And you know, RV is kind of hating it, so you got to like put some money in his pocket for his retirement. Richest guy I know. Anyway, thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next week.